This is as good as it gets when it comes to college basketball. We've said it so many times, survive and advance. And after all that anticipation, we're underway.
Up and in.
Great play. Rise and fire.
Got it.
Let's it go.
Pure.
Inside. The basket goes. And one. And he hammers it down. Watch out. Here comes the pain. Looking for some movement now at the offensive end. Wants the ball, trying to get open. With the ball at the baseline. Taking it hard to the hoop.
And one. And that one is blocked.
The junior hits that one from the parking lot.
He's been sensational.
From the corner.
Oh!
With time running out, here we go. You talk about drama. This is the greatest.
Last chance to dance. Beats the buzzer. Oh, my goodness. The slipper still fits. Heartbreak City. What a game.
Hello, I'm Jay Wright, coach of the Villanova Wildcats. As we all know, motion offense is signature to college basketball. NCAA Basketball 2010 by EA Sports debuts the motion movement control. Once you're in formation, by tapping the motion movement control, your players will quickly run a play which is unique to your motion offense. There are many different types. The dribble drive, which allows players to be creative at attacking the hoop. Dribble penetration, followed by the kick out or lob pass, is what we're looking for. The four out motion is probably the most common motion offense in college basketball. Typically, you'll see lots of screening in this offense, but one of the keys is timing. When a cut or a screening action is happening, the ball must be delivered in a timely fashion. This offense doesn't stress inside play, but having an inside presence will definitely help. The five-out motion is a great offense for teams who have post players with perimeter-type skills. This forces post defenders to leave the paint and guard his man on the perimeter. This offense really opens things up in the quarter court and will allow for back cuts and a lot of penetrate and kick opportunities. With the right mix of players, this offense can be a lot of fun to play and very difficult to defend. The Princeton offense requires all five players to be on the same page. It's not necessarily a slow offense, but is a series of quick hitter plays and reads. This offense will open things up in the quarter court. At times, the post player is situated in the high post area, about 15 to 19 feet from the hoop. A post player who can pass and make good decisions on the perimeter will be successful in this offense. Look for screens, misdirection type plays, and most of all, the back cut. Play too aggressive on the perimeter and you'll be burned on the back door cut. The Flex Motion offense utilizes a cut called the Flex Cut. This aggressive screen and cut action typically starts in the baseline corner. The cutter will use the screen and flash across the lane from the weak side to the ball side low block. Having multiple players who can post up is a definite bonus. The three out, two in motion is a great offense when you have two post players who are really skilled inside. Occasionally, the post players will step out to the perimeter to set screens for the guards. However, the guards have to know how to use the screens, know when to cut, and how to maintain good spacing. If not, the post players will not be in a good position to receive any passes and go to work. The triangle motion offense typically involves a series of reads and cuts. It's important in this offense to have three players create a triangle. One of the players is typically a post player. He'll often flash to the elbows in order to receive the pass and then deliver the backdoor pass, or he'll wait for a screening action to take place. Zone motion offenses will help you attack zone defenses. If you're facing an odd man front zone, like a 1-3-1 or a 3-2, try out the 3-low motion offense. This will position players on the baseline and two up top. Use the 2-low motion offense when going up against a 2-3 zone. 2-low will position two players down low, two players on each wings, and one up top. Either way, the key to attacking the zone is through overloading a side and passing into the high post. Pass into the high post and watch how the defense collapses into the paint. This will free up your shooters who are spotting up on the perimeter. The opportunities are endless, but it's up to you to read and react to the defense and use NCAA Basketball 2010's Motion Movement Control. Hello, I'm Jay Wright, coach of the Villanova Wildcats. Thank you.
Welcome to CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. Today's game is between the Duke Blue Devils and the Auburn Tigers. Here are two players who will need to help carry the load for their teams today. And of course, our starting lineup.
We have two excellent players at the point guard position. They usually do a great job of getting your teammates involved. Something we should definitely keep an eye on, Gus.
And while we have a moment, let's take a look at the keys for each of these teams today. So here we go. They work it around the perimeter. And he lays it up and in. He can put up points and he can move the ball.
You know, this guy can move the basketball and create his own opportunities. Really a tough guard, Gus.
On the right side. Now we've got a turnover. Length of the floor. Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
Dominating the glass.
On the left side. Heat check time from long range.
Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
Tup it inside. Shots up. Shots off. Kept alive, though. Offensive rebound. Thanks for joining CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball. I'm Gus Johnson alongside Bill Raftery. This layup is definitely worth a second look.
Gotta make those, Gus. It's incredibly deflating when you don't.
The Blue Devils now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Not this time.
Ooh. Athlete.
On the right side. He tries the three. Comes up empty from deep. The Blue Devils on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
On the outside. He shoots from the corner. And it's in. In the post. Fires the senior. This guy is really known as a power guy.
When he gets it that deep and low in the box, there's not much you can do. Say goodnight.
Nice low post play. Good entry down into the box.
Put a little English on it.
Nice pass to the low block. Shots off. Rebound. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy. Cross court. From the corner, but he misses his target. On the left side. Nice rejection. That goes out of bounds, but can stay at this end. The Blue Devils are firing on all cylinders right now.
Gosh, you know, this game can be so simple when you do it right. Balancing the floor, making the right pass, and shooting high percentage shots.